So good afternoon, everyone. So a little bit again about who am I and why am I here. So my name is Gagandeep, and as you might expect, anyone like me being on stage means that they are requesting you implicitly or explicitly to please come and visit our stall. So it's right outside over there, number 6. So I was thinking about what should be the topic of my presentation here, and I just didn't want to give any HR or L&D gyan to people who are sitting here. You guys are the experts. So I thought I'd rather talk about my journey as an entrepreneur in the L&D technology space. So to give you a little bit of background of what I was doing before that, so I was working with some well-known and some not-so-well-known companies managing their software product portfolios, doing product marketing for them, general stuff. And I did it for a very long time, more than 17 years. So then I decided to take a plunge into the startup land. And my first venture in the business side, we set out with all the josh to transform the Indian education system. So we thought we'll actually improve the teaching quality in schools using technology. Yeah, you can imagine that didn't really end well. So after hundreds of hours of painful sales conversations, getting a few customers, we realized that business is not really going anywhere. The reason for that, it was apparent to us, was, okay, were we really making a difference to the top line of the schools? No. Were we making a difference to the bottom line of the schools? Not really. So what were we really expecting? Yeah, would the schools be doing charity for us? So lessons learned, we decided we will change our business. In the startup world, there is a fancy word for it, pivot. So we pivoted. And what did we pivot to? We pivoted to the corporate L&D. Now, yeah, you would be thinking this guy didn't really learn his lessons from the school experience, because I did really feel, though Hindi mein there is a saying, "Asman se gire ke zoor par rakhe," right? So I painfully realized that if there is one department which is constantly questioned, what's your ROI? How are you impacting the top line or bottom line? That's the training department. So there it was again. Now, anyway, the decision was done. So I thought this time I'll do it differently. I'll talk to a lot of successful entrepreneurs. I'll talk to L&D experts and really figure out way to be successful fast. So I had a lot of conversations, and those conversations threw a lot of googlies at me. And those googlies I could distill in 3 points, which I would like to share with you. So the first one was something which was put forward by an L&D head of a very large US FMCG company. And he told me, he said, "Gagan, L&D is dead." And I said, "Wow, that's encouraging." The second point was put forward by a successful CEO who had sold his L&D technology company, made a lot of money. And he said, "Gagan, commodity, the L&D technology has been commoditized. So if you want to succeed in this, you have to be the cheapest. Drop your prices." Okay. The third thing was something which everyone was telling me. So whether it's L&D gurus abroad or in India, and they were telling me, you have to be the Netflix of learning, or you have to Uberize learning. Right. So all the fancy buzzwords, right, AI and so on. So at the end of this, I was wondering, I have all these golden nuggets, but what do I do with them? Luckily, in the meantime, we also were successfully able to acquire a few brands as our customers. And I realized they were using our platform quite heavily. And I also realized that they were renewing year after year. Right. So I started having more and more conversations with my customers, and I started looking at the data of our customers in our platform. What are they doing? How are they deriving value out of our system? And that gave me a new set of learnings. So So how does that compare with the old set? So I learned from my customers that yes, L&D as a traditional organization is actually dying. So they told me that learning and training is needed more than ever, but L&D is transforming itself from being an external stakeholder to be actually more integral part of business operations. So L&D was dying, but not in the way that I had initially understood. The second thing I realized was that for something to be commodity, it really has to be mastered. It has to be successfully repeated. Now, I guess most of you would share my belief here that technology and learning is far away from solving all your training problems, right? So it's not at all anywhere near being a commodity. The third thing which was clear when I talked to my customers was they didn't care about these buzzwords. They wanted to solve their business problems in the process. If some of these formed a part of the solution, fine, but this was not really the priority for them. So there I was, I had learned something, and then I had learned something more which had negated all of my previous learnings. That left me with the only learning which I had from the time we were doing business with schools, and that was, unless I am helping somebody increase their top line or bottom line, I am basically asking for charity. I realized that our customers, especially the ones who had a distributed workforce, and especially the ones in retail, they were using our platform to solve some quite unique and quite challenging problems. And due to the nature of business of retail, it is spread out. There is very high pace of change. There is high attrition. There is a lot of competition. And this gives rise to a lot of diverse training needs. Now, these needs actually vary from region to region and even store to store. And they keep on changing from time to time. They are not constant, right? So what I realized was that our customers were actually able to successfully do online training and meet these training needs. They were able to have the business impact and showcase it actually to their management, to their board. So what was my overall learning from all of this? Very simple for any entrepreneur. I understood A, understand the real problem of your customers, B, solve it, and C, charge for what you deserve. And with that, I would like to really conclude, asking you again quite explicitly to please visit our stall. I can guarantee you that we'll have a good conversation from which I'll draw out some more lessons for my business and for my next talk. Thank you.